So you've gone to great lengths to capture the cleanest audio possible. Yet, in the editing booth, you discover that no matter how careful you've been, some audio correction is inevitable. Well, we're about to show you some handy tips for correcting those all too common audio offenders, hisses and hums, using high and low pass filters, notch filters, and automated tasks, so that your footage will not only look its best, it'll sound its best too. Correcting audio anomalies may seem like a daunting task to most, but a little knowledge of basic filters and a bit of practice can go a long way towards making your audio sound as good as possible. We'll be showing you these filters in Adobe Premiere Pro CS5, but they can be found in many common editing programs as well. Let's begin by opening our editor, importing a file that needs some work, and dropping it onto the timeline. To find the filters, let's go to the Effects window and twirl down the Audio Effects folder. Here we'll see three folders entitled 5.1, Stereo, and Mono. Open the folder that corresponds to the type of audio you're working with. In our case, we're working with a stereo file, so we'll open the Stereo folder. The first filter we'll look at is the Lowpass Filter. A low-pass filter allows frequencies lower than the cutoff value to pass through while getting rid of higher frequencies. This can be useful in dealing with high-frequency hisses found in your audio. With the appropriate folder opened, locate the low-pass filter and drag it onto the clip. Click the Effect Controls tab and twirl the effect open by clicking the arrow to its left. There you'll see a bypass checkbox and a value indicator entitled Cutoff. Adjust values by clicking and typing in a value, scrubbing, or by twirling down cutoff and by using its slider. At the bottom of the effect controls window is a picture of an arrow turning back on itself. This is the toggle looping audio playback button. Click it, then click the play only the audio for this clip button to its left. While the audio clip loops, adjust the cutoff values until the hiss is eliminated, or at least reduced to a tolerable level. Finally, you can click the bypass checkbox to toggle the effect on and off so you can hear the difference. Here's how our interview audio with some high pitch electrical noises sounds without using the low pass filter.
I'm sure surfing has its dangers. What kind of things have you seen?
And here's how it sounds with using the low pass filter. Audio correction can be a give and take affair, and the best solution may be to compromise. A little bit of hiss with otherwise natural sounding audio is far better than sounding like you're filming in a barrel. A high pass filter is the opposite of a low pass filter in that it allows frequencies higher than the cutoff value to pass through while cutting off lower frequencies. When dealing with a low frequency hum, try applying the high pass filter. Twirl it open in the effect controls window and you will find the same parameters as before. The difference here is that frequencies below the cutoff will be affected. Make adjustments while looping the audio until you reach the desired result. Here's what the difference sounded like in our audio.
That's what it feels like to me, like I'm part of this whole ecosystem.
Another useful option in dealing with various offending frequencies is the notch filter. A notch filter allows most frequencies to pass, but reduces those within a specific range to very low levels. This can be particularly effective when faced with noises of a known frequency, such as an electrical hum. Let's use this filter to correct our audio clip. First, locate notch on the effects window and drop it onto your clip. Twirl it open in the effect controls and you'll see the familiar bypass checkbox, plus two additional parameters, center and Q. If the frequency is known, type it into the center value. If not, loop the audio as before and adjust the center values until you find the correct frequency. The Q value broadens the effect by determining how many frequencies will also be affected around the center value. So far, we've looked at a few audio correction filters available in common editing programs, but if you happen to own an editing suite, then you may have even more options available to you. Next, we'll take a look at one of the automated tasks found in programs like Adobe's Soundbooth CS5 and Apple's Soundtrack Pro. Reducing noise that is even throughout the entire clip, such as those caused by a fan, air conditioner, or some sort of electrical hum is easy with the cleanup tool in Soundbooth. Begin by right-clicking the clip in Adobe Premiere Timeline. go to Edit in Adobe Sound Booth, then click Render and Replace. In a few moments, Sound Booth appears with your clip loaded up and ready to go. Locate the Tasks tab and click Cleanup Audio. Underneath Noise, there are two buttons entitled Noise and Capture Noise Print, which is currently grayed out. Locate a portion of the waveform that is only the sound you wish to remove. Select it by clicking the mouse and dragging your selection around it. Sound Booth will then analyze the selected portion to determine the unwanted frequencies. With the selection made, click the Capture Noise Print button. Once the capture is complete, deselect by clicking away from the selected area, then click the Noise button to open the Noise dialog box. Here you'll find two sliders, the Reduction slider, which tells Sound Booth how aggressive to be in selecting the frequencies to reduce, and the Reduce By slider, which dictates the degree to which those selected frequencies will be adjusted down. Make sure the Use Captured Noise Print box is checked. Click Preview to loop the audio and begin adjusting the sliders. The Power button to the left of Preview toggles the effect on and off so you can hear the difference. Once you've achieved the desired result, click OK. After the effect is processed, you'll see a change in the waveform. If you followed a solid production workflow and faithfully captured room tone and other ambient noise throughout the process, you'll have little difficulty in capturing a good noise print. But what if you're working with audio that doesn't have a usable portion of background noise? Without making any selection, go straight to the Noise button and click it. You'll notice that the Use Captured Noise Print checkbox is grayed out. As before, adjust the sliders until you've achieved the result you're after. When you save and close out Sound Booth, the changes are automatically saved onto the clip back in Premiere. Here's the before and after results of our audio correction efforts.
That's what it feels like to me, like I'm part of this whole ecosystem. That's what it feels like to me, like I'm part of this whole ecosystem.
Having great audio is truly one of the most important parts of any video and may mean the difference between audiences standing up and cheering or standing up and walking out. By using the tools we've shown you, you can be sure that your video will sound as good as it looks.